now, here is Lucinda Williams.
Austin was a real magical place when I first moved here in 74. I was 21 and, you know, just really just getting started with my music and everything. And it's been one of those things where Austin's always claimed me as one of their own. I spent so much time here, and a lot of my changes were here, you know. Just that was such an important, crucial time in my career.
I've never been with you all along. I just want to see it so bad. I just want to see it so bad.
This is called Something About What Happens When We Talk.
It's that unique ability that she has to weave a story in a song, to bring the characters in a song, whether they are about herself or just entirely invented, bring them to life in a way that people can relate to.
If I had my way, I'd be in your town.
There are very few songwriters who have that unique ability to really tell a story that's almost like a novel condensed into 3 to 5 minutes.
Something about what happens when we talk.
I feel like Lucinda's music has always painted a picture where I felt like I was there with her, like a photo album that she was describing for me of her life that I also connected to in my life. It was romantic and nostalgic, and even before I knew what those words meant as a teenager, as I've grown older, I feel like I only connect with it more deeply because it's all the things I aspire to write about myself.
Something about what happens when we talk.
When Lucinda started doing what she did and writing the songs that she did and putting out records like she did, there was no such thing as Americana. But it's people like Lucinda Williams who made Americana music what it is today. She helped to lay the foundation. She defied the efforts by the music business to categorize or put a label on her music or on her songs.
All the way.
When my song Passionate Kisses, which was recorded by Mary Chapin Carpenter, won a Grammy for Best Country Song. And the irony of all that is, of course, it's not a country song, but also when Chapin wanted it to be the first single off her album, and her record label said they didn't want to do that because it wasn't country enough.
She didn't give a hoot. She just mixed it all up, and basically, whether it was folk or blues or rock or whatever, it was Lucinda Williams. And each one of those songs reflected a part of who she is.
All the way to Jackson, I don't think I'll miss you much.
This is where we proceed to rock your world.
With her writing, you can tell in the emotion of her voice that whether it's about her or about someone else, she just feels it so deeply. Whether it be playful or darker emotions, you can just tell that it's something that she cares so deeply about.
I don't want you anymore 'cause you took my joy. I don't want you.
That takes a lifetime of internalizing pain and externalizing it into music, and I feel like you can hear all of her history in her voice as she continues to slay audiences. I'm just so proud of her for being recognized. She deserves every bit of it.
Since so much of Austin City Limits is based around the singer-songwriter tradition across all genres, there's no one who really defines the art of songwriting and with a more distinctive voice than Lucinda Williams. We're thrilled to have Lucinda in this year's class of the Austin City Limits Hall of Fame.